In this video, we will implement a CI/CD process for data workflows. We're gonna use only open source tools, so you can reproduce this entire demo free of charge. We'll use Terraform to implement infrastructure as code, and Kestra for declarative data orchestration. Let's start by explaining what is Terraform. Terraform allows developers to define and maintain resources using a human-readable, cloud-agnostic configuration. Using Terraform, you can automate provisioning and managing changes to your infrastructure using declarative code defined in HashiCorp configuration language. Let's look at an example. Here is a Terraform configuration required to provision an S3 bucket. First, we define the provider requirements. Here we use AWS. The source tells Terraform where to download this provider from. And the version constraint helps to ensure that the provider package is compatible with our configuration. The provider section configures settings for the provider, including region and credentials. The default profile indicates that we want to use the default profile from a locally stored AWS credentials file. Finally, we declare an S3 bucket resource, and we specify the required attributes, such as the bucket name. Note that we didn't say how to create and manage the bucket. We only declare that it should exist with the properties that we want. This is possible thanks to the declarative approach, which means that you describe the desired outcome rather than the steps to reach that outcome. Terraform compares that to the current state of the infrastructure, which is stored in the terraform.tf state file. The user doesn't need to know whether a component needs to be provisioned, modified, or destroyed. What's declared in the configuration is what gets compared to the current state and applied in order to reach the desired state you declared. When you run Terraform apply, Terraform compares the infrastructure definition in code with the current state. Based on those differences, or lack thereof, it determines whether any changes are necessary. In this example, the S3 bucket had to be created. We'll now use Terraform to deploy Kestra resources. To deploy data workflows to Kestra, we can leverage the official Terraform provider. We'll focus on deploying only flows, but I encourage you to check the provider documentation for a full list of supported resources. Let's start by creating a file main.tf and set Kestra as the required provider. Note that the 0.7.0 indicates the version of the provider, not the version of Kestra. You can use any version of Kestra with the Terraform provider. Here's a Hello World example. It will deploy only one resource of type Kestra flow. It consists of ID, namespace, and content of the flow. This inline syntax with the end of file marker is best for use cases when we want to pass variables from other Terraform resources to our flows. In this example, we pass the bucket name to the flow that uses that bucket. This way, your infrastructure and data pipelines are in sync. In the same way, we can reference variables to avoid repeating ourselves. Here we define the namespace as a variable and pass it to the flow to ensure that infrastructure and workflow definition are both defined as code in a consistent way without duplication. However, you don't have to write your flows inline in Terraform. Instead, you can also leverage the template file function. This function points to an existing YAML file. One downside of this syntax is that flow ID and namespace are defined twice, once in the flow YAML definition and once here in the Terraform resource. But there's an easy way to avoid a duplication. You can leverage the YAML decode function to retrieve the flow ID and namespace from YAML and use it in the Terraform definition. Retrieving the ID and namespace from the flow code is particularly useful when you want to automate deployment of multiple flows stored in the same directory. Imagine you have hundreds of workflows. Instead of explicitly defining the path to every single flow file, we can use the Terraform fileset function to list all flows from the flows directory and deploy each of them to Kestra. This setup is convenient because it will automatically discover and deploy all flows from a given directory. Terraform will automatically detect if there are any new, changed, or deleted flows. And the entire setup is just a single file with 20 lines of code. So far, we've covered the process conceptually. Now let's see it in action. You can use this repository template. I've already cloned this repository in my terminal, and we can start by installing Terraform. Once we have Terraform, we can download the Docker Compose file, and then we will be able to start Kestra containers using Docker Compose app. We then run Terraform init to download the Terraform provider, and then we can validate the syntax using Terraform validate. Finally, we run Terraform apply to deploy our flows. Here we can see that 6 flows have been deployed. And now we can go to the UI to inspect the results. We go to flows, and we can see that 6 new flows have been deployed, and we can inspect them for the relevant namespace. That's all we have for today. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.